My name is Mary Jo Foley. I'm your community magnate on Petri.com. I'm here to introduce you to someone who you already probably know, and if you don't, you should. This is Tony Redmond. He is the chair of the Office 365 Engage Conference, which is coming up in Haarlem, Netherlands, June 19th to the 22nd. So if you don't know Tony, he also is an MVP and an author of a book that I've found myself quite invaluable, Office 365 for IT Pros. It's an ebook that he updates twice weekly, I believe, or weekly, because there's so much happening in Office 365. Tony also writes for Petri.com twice a week. So, Tony, I hear from my sources that you are the chair of this conference that's coming up. And so I'd like to know kind of what guided your thinking in terms of choosing the theme, the tracks, and the content for this event.
Well, good afternoon, Madam
Good
Magnus.
Afternoon.
I guess I can't really do disclaim responsibility at this stage. I am responsible for choosing the content that we're going to be presenting in Haarlem in June. And so to begin, I say the theme of the conference is all about maybe maximizing the use that people get from Office 365. And in another way, it's all about breaking free of on-prem, because on-prem is a history, it's been fantastic, but it's time to move on. So what we want to do is maximize the use of the cloud, maximize the use of Office 365, and help people get value for the investment, for the subscriptions that they pay. And that we need to, we need to spread the news about what's new inside Office 365. It changes all the time. You said the book, we actually update the book weekly. Updating it twice weekly would be impossible. But anyway.
Weekly is a lot too, but
I'm glad you do.
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks. But that just reflects the amount of change that's in inside Office 365. So I guess by getting people together once a year, we can reflect on what's happened in the last year, and we can say, well, this is what we think is really good, this is what we think is something you may want to stay away from, and this is what might happen in the future. And we're not influenced by Microsoft in any way. It's totally independent. It's our view of what's happening. And so to communicate that news, we have very deliberately selected speakers that we think can give that kind of independent attitude, that independent voice, independent opinion about what's really important inside Office 365. We've got 31 MVPs coming along, which I think is fantastic.
Wow.
It's most MVPs you're going to see at any event outside of Microsoft Ignite, and they're all selected because they have the right attitude, the right credibility, the right credentials, and the ability to get the message across. So I'm really looking forward to the event.
Yeah, that's great, because I know when I've gone to a number of events around the Microsoft communities that sometimes you feel like it's the speaker circuit. Like there's some people
Yes.
who are amazing speakers, but you feel like you've heard their talk. And so now I'm kind of excited to hear these new MVPs, kind of people who are a little like hidden gems in the community.
Yep. You're right. There's a lot of events like that. We want to get away
yeah.
from that. Yeah.
That's good. I like that. And, you know, speaking of events, there are so many Office 365 events
yep.
or events that touch on Office 365. So what makes this event different or unique? You know, what would somebody say would make them be willing to spend the money and the time and invest that in coming to this event versus one of many others?
Yeah, it's a good question, because clearly people have got limited training dollars and
right.
they have to make a decision maybe how they're going to spend that money, to what events they're going mm-hmm. to do. I guess I would point to a couple of things. I think first thing, we take a very holistic view of Office 365. It's the service, it's everything in Office 365. We don't want to limit ourselves to speaking in just about SharePoint, just about Exchange, just about mm-hmm. Skype. We want to take that view of how can you get advantage of everything that happens inside Office 365. That's the first thing. And I think the second thing is just the quality of the speakers. It's an incredible mm-hmm. bunch of folks mm-hmm. that we've asked to come along. And then the third thing is that Haarlem's just a great place to hold an event. It's going to be a small, intimate event. It's not going to be one of those mega events where you get the opportunity of lining up at 15,000 of your closest friends for a splendid meal of bologna. You're not going to have that. You're just going to have the opportunity to get some great knowledge in a great location, and maybe have some nice meals and experiences afterwards, just interpreting the finer points of Office 365, which only happen in a bar after midnight.
Very true.
Very
especially
true.
If you like craft beer. I got to go to Haarlem last year, so I can attest there's some good beer.
Oh, yes, definitely. Yes.
So if you're somebody who already is familiar with Office 365 and you're working with it now, what would you get out of coming to this conference? Because, you know, I feel like, okay, a lot of people, they may not be experts, but they feel like they're pretty savvy about Office 365. So what would they gain now if they haven't gone to a conference recently or, say, you know, haven't kept up with the news about Office 365?
Yeah, great question. I think the answer to that is probably found in the fact that we're 6 years along the Office 365 journey. It seems like it's gone by just boom. Yeah. But it is 6 years. And 6 years ago, when we think about the technology that was there, we really just had a loose collection of what you might call cloudified on-prem applications. I mean, it was basically Exchange 2010 and SharePoint 2010 with a little bit of Office 365 and some magic fairy dust, and that was Office 365, June 2011. Now, I think we really have moved so much further. The first thing is that Microsoft is focusing much more on new applications. It's focusing on taking the existing applications and using them as a form of software toolkit that can be used to build the new applications. And we're seeing stuff that just didn't exist a number of years ago. I mean, even in the last year, we've seen things like Teams, which is a tremendously exciting application for many people. We've seen Staff Hub, which is a good example of how you can leverage off the platform. But more importantly, we've seen a great deal of maturity coming in applications like Office 365 Groups, which now are increasingly serving as a form of management, membership management and identity management service for other apps. And, you know, when you see that kind of thing happening, you've got to say, wow, this service, this infrastructure is really maturing in a lot of different ways. And if I don't stay on top of what's happening, I'm going to lose the opportunity to understand how I can take advantage of what Microsoft is doing. And the other thing is, too, I think we have to look at the investment that Microsoft is putting in here. I mean, there's a huge investment. When you think about the data centers, they just opened up data centers now in South Korea. There's more coming along. That's 13 separate Office 365 regions that are out there. When you look at the number of servers that are running in, you know, some of them in the region of 140,000 for Exchange Online alone, you know, it's quite incredible. And they are using that infrastructure to create this incredible framework that just needs to be exploited. You can't exploit it without knowledge. You can't exploit it without the knowledge of real experts. We've got the experts come along and talk to us.
Yeah, I feel like, you know, my whole job is writing news about Microsoft as my day job, and I never can keep up with Office 365. Thanks. Yeah. But Office 365, it just feels like every single day you could write something about a new feature. It's crazy how fast it's changing.
And I think the more important thing is every day you could write about a new detail about a feature that they released 3 weeks ago.
True.
Because it's a constant journey of exploration to find out how things actually work. You know, Microsoft, I think the Microsoft documentation team for Office 365 must be the hardest job on the planet right now.
Yeah.
Because just keeping TechNet or whatever they call it today up to date with what's happening, mm-hmm. it's incredibly difficult.
It is.
So
for sure.
That's the reason why if you mm-hmm. can't do it on your own, you can at least come together with a group of people who are really interested in knowing the detail, and they'll share the information with you, and that's what we're all about.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Okay, so now I'm going to ask you a tough one. It's like asking a parent to pick their favorite child, but
the red one.
As the conference chair, I'm curious what sessions you're really excited about. You know, which sessions would you recommend for people who are Office 365 pros or newbies or even haters, because there are haters out there. And, you know, I guess I'm asking you to kind of give us your top picks.
And I'm going to decline that opportunity because I don't want to offend some of my MVP colleagues. I do have my own little list, which is hidden mm-hmm. away, but I'm not really going to come out. And simply because, you know, as we have this chat, we're still roughly 2 months away from the conference. Mm-hmm. And as we've discussed, Office 365 changes all the time. So one of the things I've already communicated to the speakers is that they've got to be prepared to change. I don't expect to see a deck provided in 6 weeks before the conference, that is what they're going to present. I expect them to be flexible and adaptable to what happens inside Office 365. So for all we know, maybe you do know because you've got some tip that I don't know of, but maybe there's going to be some massive new application that comes out that we say, oh my gosh, we need two sessions on that. I don't know. So all I can say is that we will do our level best, and every speaker will be held accountable for this, to provide the best and most up-to-date coverage of Office 365 as it is in June 2017 in Haarlem. That's all we can try and do. And, they're all great speakers. But, you know, what I would pick, what you would pick, what somebody else would pick, it'll be totally different. Come along and have a look. And if you're a hater, I don't know, come along and go to one of those coffee shop type places and be mellow. Be very mellow. And then come along and talk to us.
That's good. I like your advice there. So see you in Haarlem, Tony. I'll be there too. And hopefully we can share a pint, maybe at a share pint, sure, or other places too.
Sure. Lots of places to talk. And there's one thing about Office 365, there'll always be things to talk about.
That's true.
Okay. Good talking with you.
Yeah, you too. Thanks.
Ciao.